But I'll tell you what, the engine that drives this group, it's this guy right here, 19. There's a lot to like in this play. I've kind of teased out two to kind of help you understand the hockey IQ. Surveys the situation. There's pressure inside. I don't really have a good scoring play. There's nobody in support. A lot of guys, lots, would go ahead and they would take that shot. It's a low percentage shot, but a lot of guys would take it. What does he do? He checks up. He lays it back to Backlund. And Backlund, on the other hand, makes a great little pass over to Frolik for Frolik's first of the night. Great play there. Here's one he's not even going to assist on, but what I really like about it, lots, watch his positioning. This is really smart hockey. Stops right there on Pasternak rather than swing by him, and a lot of guys would swing by him. What does he do by doing that? He stops and he forces Pasternak into a really small space so that Backlund can come down from above rather than opening up a lane where Pasternak might be able to actually jump into the middle and carry the puck out. That forces the turnover. And again, Backlund to Frolik. Kachuk doesn't get an assist on that play, but he made it happen because he stopped rather than swung and created a really small space for that almost scissor-like attack where Backlund could come down from above and create the turnover. Smart player, smart game. Comes from the lineage, I suspect. There's a lot of hockey going on in the Kachuk blood.
Yeah, there's no doubt Keith and his wife, Chantel, they did an amazing job, not just with Matthew, but also with Brady from what we've seen of him. He's injured now, but Keith was a great guy when he played, and he was a hard-nosed player. He somehow, between him and his wife, they've taken the best qualities of Keith and put them into their two kids in terms of how you act as a professional. Yeah. On and off the ice, because these are two of the nicest young men I've met in the game, both the sons. I did get the pleasure to get to know Keith and Chantel when they were in Arizona and I was living down there. And Keith was a little rough.
Oh, yeah.
Keith could be rough at times. I mean, just even as a teammate. But his kids are spot on everything in terms of how they handle themselves, whether it's with the media, whether it's off the ice, whether it's with a specific play that happens on the ice. I'm watching Brady, and I can't believe the impact he was having in Ottawa this early in his career. We're watching Matthew, and we had a big discussion his first year after 9 games. He didn't have a ton of points, and somebody was up here with me arguing about, you got to send this guy back to junior. He's not doing it. He's not ready. I said, are you crazy? This guy's done everything. Yeah. Every game you could ask for from a player, it doesn't matter if he hasn't scored yet. He will. He's playing the game the right way. Incredibly valuable player for the Calgary.
It's an interesting aspect, though. I really like to talk about this because it's no guarantee you're born to an NHL father that you're going to become an NHL player. But it really, when it does work out, you've got that opportunity or you've got those raw physical skills. The maturity really is the difference maker, I think. You know, there are all those evenings of sitting around the dinner table and at the amateur level, Matthew and Brady are going
through. Here's the salt shaker.
Exactly.
Here's the pepper shaker. You're F1 and you're F2 and they're you move here and there and
they're going
that's
through
dinner.
They're going through the peaks and valleys of what is, you know, a really challenging amateur career, but they've got their father in their ear telling them, here's how you kind of even out those peaks and valleys. And you can see it when these guys step into NHL locker rooms, they're 3, 4, maybe more years ahead of the curve, just in terms of their maturation. Matthew Tkachuk, a really young guy, he's an emotional leader inside that Calgary Flames locker room. He's an important part of
that. Which is incredible at this age.
It really is.
Well, there's 3 or 4 years ahead because they're inside those rooms at 3 and 4 years of age.
Yes. Right.
Kind of, they're not intimidated the first time they walk inside.
You're just soaking up all this stuff by osmosis.
Exactly.
You soak it up. You learn by observing if it's not, you know, a direct conversation with your father.
And like you said, still have to have the skill sets to get there. And both the Tkachuk boys certainly do.